And Hanuri and Ilganori for a sensational opening act.
박수 다시 한번 부탁드릴게요. 자, 미주한 봉사교육단체 20주년 그리고 민족학교 설립 기념 31주년에 오신 여러분들 정말 환영합니다.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you all so much for coming to celebrate the 20th anniversary of NACASAC and the 31st anniversary of the Korean Resource Center.
감사합니다. 저는 오늘 우리말 진행을 맡은 손그린이고요. 제 옆에 계신 분은 홍주영 씨, 저희 영어 진행을 맡아주셨어요.
I am honored to be the MC for tonight's program. My name is Jun Hong, aka Obama Heckler. And just a funny story, you know, I was at the bar with my friends, and somebody just tapped into my shoulder. Hey, which is the guy who interrupted the president of Gangnam Style?
And
I didn't even drink yet, so.
중간중간에 한잔 하시고 싶다, 또 주홍씨 이런 춤을 또 보고 싶다 그러시면 계속 가셔서 한잔 사가지고 다시 오시면 되세요.
That's correct. Thank you. Efforts have greatly contributed to our lives.
올해 만찬의 주제는 아시는지 모르겠지만 함께 이루는 미래입니다. 여기 모이신 여러분, 모든 여러분들 그리고 참석하지 못하신 하지만 고민하고 같이 참여해주신 많은 분들이 민족학교에 그리고 미교협과 우리 미래를 일궈 나가는 주인공들이십니다.
This year's theme is building a movement for change. All of you here tonight, and as well as those who cannot be here but continue to support our efforts, are heroes of KRC and NACASAC, and ultimate hope for the future of our Korean American community.
저희 주인공들 중에서 아직까지 회원에 가입하지 않으신 분들이 있으시면 테이블 위에 프로그램 북이 있어요. 그 안에 회원 가입록 테이블에 다시 제출하시면 되세요.
And if any of you have yet to become a
전에 제가 오늘 만찬을 위해 수고해주
Before we begin the program, we would like to recognize. Please stand up so we can acknowledge yourself. Host committee.
Thank you.
그리고 오늘 만찬을 성공리에 개최할 수 있도록 후원해 주신 모든 후원자들께도 정말 감사의 말씀을 전달해서 활동을 펼치고 계시는 이강남 선생님, 그리고 민족학교의 이사장님이신 이기주 선생님, 그리고 미교협의 이사장을 맡고 계시는 강완모 선생님, 그리고 민족학교와 미교협의 주상호 국장님을 무대로 모시겠습니다.
First. We have Kangnam Lee, a current board member of KRC and leader of KRC's senior organizing group. Second, we have King Joo Lee, KRC's board president. Next, we have Wanmo Kang, NACASAC's board chair. And lastly, we have KRC and NACASAC's executive directors, Hee Joo Yoon and Dae Jung Yoon. All have worked tirelessly for social change in our community. So please help me welcome all the five members in our community.
네, 다섯 분을 굉장히 참 든든한데요. 이강남 선생님, 어떻게 민족학교와 인연을 맺게 되셨고 또 가장 기억에 남으시는 일이 어떤 게 있을까요?
안녕하세요. 반갑습니다.
And we have the translations available on the screen.
이강남입니다. 저는 5년 전에 나파카 직업 훈련 프로그램에 의해서 민족학교와 인연이 됐습니다. 2년간 민족학교에서 근무하면서 민족학교가 과연 우리 커뮤니티에 얼마나 중요한 단체인가를 제가 알게 됐습니다. 더불어서 우리 그 비영리 단체에서 보기 드문 연장자 모임인 가로리 모임이 있다는 것도 알게 됐습니다. 네, 2년간 근무 끝나고 퇴직하고 가보리 모임에 제가 들어갔는데요. 그 가보리 모임은 여러분들께서 잘 아시다시피 가주 보건 리더 모임의 첫자를 따서 가보리 모임입니다. 이 모임에 등록된 인원은 약 한 150여 명 되고요. 매달 넷째 주 금요일 날이면 저희들이 모임을 갖습니다. 그 모임에는 항상 35명에서 40명 선 이렇게 참석을 하고 있습니다. 그간에 저희들이 하는 일은 민족학교 살아에 있기 때문에 민족학교에서 어떤 이슈를 가지고 일을 하실 때 저희들이 전부 다 협조를 했습니다. 이민 개혁 문제, 또 그 오바마 케어 문제 이런 문제도 전부 다 저희들이 서명 문서도 받았고요. 또 그 결실로 저희들이 지금 덴탈 치과 혜택도 금년 5월부터 받게 됐습니다. 그 치과가 보험으로 되지 않아 가지고 우리 연장자분들이 많은 고통을 겪고 있는 걸 알고 다보리 모임에서 전부 협조. 현재는 노인 인구는 불어나는데 주택 문제가 부족해 가지고 되겠다 해 가지고 현재 모든 예산 문제를 이 주택을 지어주십사 하고 지금 캠페인과 더불어서 서명 운동을 받고 있습니다. 우리가 덴탈 문제도 해결했다시피 그의 여러 스태프들이 얼마나 열심히 일을 하시는데요. 저희들이 진짜 살려서 도와드리고 싶은 그런 마음에서 저희 가보리 모임이 이렇게 운동을 하고 있고요. 현재 제가 바라보니까 여기 중간에 우리 가보리 모임들이 많이 와 계시네요. 연장자들이시면 앞으로 건강하시고 우리가 모든 사업에 같이 협조해서 잘해 나갈 수 있도록 여러분께서 박수 한번 쳐주세요. 네. 저희들이 가보리 모임을 하면서 홍주 부탁드리겠습니다.
와, 몇 년 동안 그렇게 고대하던 노예업이 오늘에 이르기 전까지는 초기에 많은 어려움들이 있었다고 그랬는데요. 어떠세요? 이기치 이사장님, 초기에는 어땠는지 좀 설명 좀 해주시겠어요?
네. 저는 지금부터
Translation's available on the right side.
31년 전에 민족학교에 발을 들여놓게 됐습니다. 그래서 여지까지 후원자로서 일하고 있는데요. 제일 첫 번째가 1983년에 민족학교가 Yes, when we just founded in 1983, we founded the KRC. And the first thing we come up with the thing is that all these people have been strange looking at, like us, like all, you know. It's very dangerous people who has a different ideology. But, you know, even now, some people do. And another thing is come up with a fund to run the KRC. And we started fundraising, doing garage sales, and even selling the flowers on the street, and whatever we can do to raise the fund. Like even now, we are doing the one-day dining program. So I really thank you for any of you who came to our one-day dining and supported us. Thank you.
네, 초기 어려웠던 시절은 아무리 들어도 정말 상상이 잘 되질 않는데요. 저희 민족학교와 미교협의 정신 중에 하나가 헝그리 정신이죠. 자, 강안모 이사님께서 네, 한 말씀 더 하세요.
잠깐 제가 한 말씀을 빠뜨렸습니다. 가장 기쁜 소식인데요. 저희들이 그렇게 염원했던 그 부지를 두고도 집을 못 줬잖아요. 그런데 이번 10월 달에 아파트 70채를 짓게 되었습니다. 이렇게 협조해주신 리틀 도쿄 서비스 센터 관계자 여러분들께 감사합니다. 너무
네, 이제 강완모 이사님께서 민족학교와 미교협의 헝그리 정신으로 이번 핸드 이 중에 하이라이트를 좀 말씀드릴까 해요.
잘 들리나요? 잘 들리나요? 예, 더 맛있게 드시면서 잠깐 저희들 말씀을 좀 들어주시면 고맙겠습니다. 우리가 이 한인 사회에 많은 단체들이 많이 있어요. 그런데 제가 오늘 여기 나오기 전에 도대체 이 민족학교하고 미주한인봉사교육단체협의회, KRC, 낙가세기 도대체 수많은 단체들 중에 우리가 뭐가 좀 특별한 것이 뭐가 있을까 하는 그런 생각을 해봤어요. 그랬더니 제가 생각할 수 있는 것이 우리는 정말 커뮤니티의 뿌리를 깊이 내리고 커뮤니티 속에서 자라나온 이 풀뿌리, 정말 그레스루트 베이스드 오가네이션이라는 것이 가장 자랑스러운 큰 특징이고, 또 하나는 수많은 단체가 있지만은 우리 이민자들의 권리, 그 다음에 소수민족으로서의 우리 권리, 그 다음에 미국에서 우리들이 주어진 권리, 시빌 라이트 이런 것들을 찾아서, 그 다음에 좀 어려운 형편에 있는 분들, 이런 분들을 위해서 생각을 하고 활동을 하는 소셜 저스티스를 생각하고, 조금 우리보다 좀 관심을 필요로 하는 사람들을 돌봐주는 이러한 조금 생각을 가진 단체, 이것이 우리가 생각할 수 있는 단체가 아닌가 이런 생각이 들어요. 그래서 The Largest National Korean American Community Based Civil Rights Organization, 이것이 지난 31년, 20년 우리가 살아나온 그것이 아닐까 생각을 합니다. 그 중에서 그것을 보여주는 가장 대표적인 우리의 활동이 하나 생각이 나요. 그게 뭐냐면은 90년대 중반에 미국에서 그냥 이민자들은 완전히 뭐 무슨 범죄인 취급하고, 딴 나라에서 온 완전히 미국에서 섞이지 않는 세컨 클래스 시티즌으로 생각하는 그러한 반이민 정서가 상당히 넘쳐 흘러났을 때였어요. 그래서 우리들이 어떻게 우리 이민자들의 권리를 지키고 이민자들이 좀 제대로 인간적으로 취급받는 사회를 어떻게 만들까 해서 우리가 생각을 해낸 것이, 미국에서 많은 여론의 영향을 미칠 수 있는 워싱턴 포스트에다가 전면 광고를 한번 실자. 우리 이민자들이 이렇고 미국은 이민자 나라고 우리도 정당한 대우를 받고 싶다. 뉴욕타임즈를 하려고 했더니 돈이 너무 비쌌어요. 전면 광고가. 그래서 워싱턴 포스트가 전면 광고 하나 하는데 2만 5천 불이었어요. 그 많은 돈이 우리한테 어디 있겠어요, 우리가. 그래서 모든 사람들이 나가서 이 마켓에 이런 데 나가서 한 두 달 정도 한 사람이 1불씩 모금하는 운동을 벌였어요. 그런데 놀랍게도 우리가 목표했던 것보다 훨씬 많은 5만 불 이상이라는 돈을 우리가 모았어요. 그래서 워싱턴 포스트에다가 전면 광고를 두 차례나 실었어요. 그 워싱턴 포스트를 모든 상하 의원들이 읽어보고 백악관에 전달되고, 그것이 아직도 미국에서 이민자들의 권익 공호를 위한 활동에 큰 불을 지핀, 그것을 자랑스럽게 우리 코리안 아메리칸들이 했다는 것을, 정말 그런 미국의 메인스트림 운동단체에서 지금도 전설적으로 예의되고 있는 그런 거였어요. 그것 하면은 이렇게 해낼 수 있고, 그것이 오늘날 미 전국에서 가장 큰 시빌 라이트 오가나이제이션으로 자라났고 아시안 아메리칸 커뮤니티에도 큰 영향을 미치는 그런 거라고 생각을 합니다. 여러분들 바랍니다.
Mr. Gong, thank you so much for your efforts and grassroots organizing. And I would like to introduce our next speaker, KRC Executive Director, Hee-Ju, to introduce some of the other work that KRC does for our community.
Yes, first of all, thank you for coming tonight. And don't worry, I'm going to make short the long story. And one of our core programs is civic engagement. Since 1996, we have educated Korean-American voters. We produced the bilingual voter guide, and we make phone calls, and we visited the Korean-American voters' house to encourage them to vote. So each election, we get better to this work. And as you already know, the Korean-American community in Southern California is the largest in the U.S. and expanding from Los Angeles to Orange County. So last year, KRC started its service desk within the Orange County Labor Federation office. So where is Orange County Labor Federation? Yes, let's give a big hand to the Orange County Labor Federation. Thank you for supporting us. And also, we are working closely with OCO, OCORD, and OCAPTA to make a better Orange County. And lastly, I'm so excited to share that our KRC will be opening our own Orange County office soon, maybe next month. So our new office is, yes. So our office is located at the Beach Boulevard and Commoners Avenue in Buena Park. And we're going to invite all of you to our open house in mid-September. Please come. Thank you.
Thank you, Heejun. I'm glad that Orange County is now opening in KRC. Congratulations once again. And next, I would like to introduce NACASAC Executive Director, DJ.
Good evening, everyone. How's the dinner? Smells good. If you want, I can talk to our board president and make sure that you can take it home. The grateful you have. You know, we are really humble and very honored to be here with you because we couldn't be here without your support and your concern. So we'd like to really appreciate, and I cannot find any right word to really, you know, appreciate all our, you know, thank you to all your support and your partnership. So thank you and give yourself a big hand. Today is a celebration of our partnership and all your great work. There are so many things, like our senior leader, Ms. Lee, mentioned, because of our partnership at LTAC, we are building a 70 unit of affordable senior housing starting from this October. Yeah, LTAC. As a board president, Jerber, we spent, and we're not giving up, right? Right. And as he mentioned, because of, you know, OC Labor Federation, we had a small office, small one desk in their building, and we've been serving Orange County, right? But now, because of their support partnership, KRC will have a second office in Orange County on Beach Boulevard, opening in October. So thank you. You know, nowadays, my happiest moment is when show me their driver license and show me their working permit and share their hope and dream. I want to be an organizer. I want to be a social worker. I want to be a teacher. That is a great moment. But you know what? That moment, it wasn't given. We own that, right? After many, many years, we fought together and we won that. So now young people, regardless of their paper immigration status, those young people who are qualified, they can apply for DACA. I think DACA is one example how we work together. When DACA was announced in June 2012, from there to August, it was crazy. It was very emotional. I remember just 1 month alone in 2012, KRC, NACASAC, our three offices, we received more than 5,000 calls from 180 cities, from 28 states, immigrant parents, immigrant students, looking for information, looking for opportunity. And respect for our community, we gotta fight for immigration. But now, this summer, we have to demand, we have to announce executive order, administrative relief, expand the DACA. So many young,
I'm my heroes in 31 years. When we started the KRC first in 1983, we didn't have any fund. We didn't have any fund from the funders, so no money. So we were struggling raising the monthly rent for the tiny little room. and a little bigger of just a hall like, and that was all we have, and it was we were struggling. And I would like to thank all those for let's see, 1983 to 2000, we didn't have any paid employees, you know, staffs. So for that time, all this full-time, non-paid, full-time, devoted staff members and volunteers, I really thank them. And another thing is when KRC started, in this small hall, we had a, we used it as a, like a meeting room, activity room, or that lecture room, and to some, the bedroom. So, and at that time, I would like to acknowledge all these non-paid full-time staff members. And one more thing is that at that room, we had a great, great lecture. The famous professors came and gave us a free lecture. And I'm so happy to, some of them are here with us. I'm very grateful. It's been very memorable lectures that we had, education. And so without these heroes and you all, you know, all of you, without you, we couldn't be here tonight. Thank you so much.
박수 드릴게요. 네, 드루셔티에서는 정말 여러분의 정성이 필요한데요. 오늘 특별히 여러분의 후원비나 그리고 이제 가입을 하시게 되면은 매칭 100% 매칭 펀드가 된대요. 그래서 만약에 50불을 뭐 도네이션 하고 싶다 이러면은 100불이 되는 거예요. 나는 50불밖에 안 되는데 이게 100불이 됐네? 이거 완전히 1 플러스 1이네? 이렇게 올해만 특별히 100% 저희가 매칭 펀드가 있는데요. 저희 프로그램 북 안에 보시면 도네이션 폼이 있기 때문에 꼭 작성하시고 나가실 때 가서 레지스트레이션 테이블에 나와주시면 정말 감사하겠습니다.
You see, DJ did that for himself. He did this for our community. He cares about undocumented immigrant youth. He cares about undocumented immigrant parent who's carrying a detention center, who got deported with unjust laws. But you see, he cannot do it himself. That is why we need your help. That's why GreenS, we need to make the sign to become a member of our organization before you leave tonight. And so please note that if you sign up today, become a member, this year every dollar you donate will be matched by a funder. So if you sign up for our dream membership, which is only about 50 bucks, we can get 100% match to receive a double amount, which is $100 in funding. So we have a really good chance to raise enormous amounts of funding with your help tonight. You see, I'm undocumented, unafraid, and unemployed, and I'm broke. And tonight I will sign up for a dream membership. $50. So if I can do it, you can do it too. So please.
50불 하시는데 여러분도 하실 수 있습니다. 네.
So I will strongly encourage you to consider to sign up today. And donation form is inside the program book. Obama to expand deeper action for all and put an end to the deportation of our hardworking immigrant families across the country. So please take a moment to sign the postcards that are at the center of each of your tables. We plan to deliver those postcards to the White House later this month. So please consider to sign.
다섯 분이 짤막짤막하게 소개해 주셨는데요. 여러분의 후원이 있었기에 지금이 있는
accomplishments throughout the KRC's 31 years and NACSX 20 years. And just a one quick note, throughout this program, there's a cash bar in the next door, so you can grab a quick drink and wine if you like.
제가 저녁 내내 옆에 캐시바가 있거든요. 앤 커리 씨께서 먼 걸음 하셔서 오늘 오셨어요. 도산 안창호 씨, 선생님과 또 실장 선생님이 저희 한인 이민자들이 어떻게 살아야 하는지 정말 저희 이민자들의 선구자라고 하실 수 있죠?
Now there's a special guest attendance today. No, it's not Mr. President. There's a granddaughter of the great Korean educator and activist, Dusan An Chung-ho. Her name is Susan Ann Cuddy, and she is 100 years old. And we are honored by her attendance today. So can we give a big round of applause?
Next. 다음은 수상자들을 발표해 드리겠습니다. 먼저 정의상 수상자들을 발표할 텐데요. 민족학교에서 이민자 권익 프로젝트를 맡아서 수고해 주신 크리스토 백, 저희 민족학교 보드 멤버시죠? 를 소개하겠습니다.
Now we are in the part of the core of the program. But I know that right now there's a food gathering. I hope that you will just pay a close attention while you eat. But we'll start the core of the program. Next, we'll present tonight's award winners. We would like to first start off by introducing the recipients of the Standing Up for Justice Award, Crystal Bate, Korean Research Center board member. Will introduce our first recipient. So please help me welcome Crystal.
So good evening, everyone. I'm really happy to be here with all of you. And on the behalf of NACASEC, and KRC, I have the honor of announcing the first recipient of the Standing Up for Justice Award, the Legal Aid Foundation of Los Angeles, or LAFLA. And on behalf of LAFLA, we have Joanne Lee, who will be receiving the award. But before Joanne comes up, I want to just give a brief description of the organization that will bring her up. So for the past 85 years, LAFLA has provided free legal services to low-income people in Los Angeles County through direct representation, broader advocacy efforts, and community education, with six neighborhood offices, three domestic violence clinics, and an additional 35,000 litigants who are helped through LAFLA's self-
for broader change. But through our work with KRC and NACASEC, I can say with certainty that we have seen real transformation in individual lives and through systemic change. Through the years, I, as well as many of our LAFLA staff members, have encountered numerous community members through our work and partnership with KRC and NACASEC. Many of their stories have stayed with me over the years, helping me to widen my perspectives, understand different struggles. They have tugged at my heart and stayed with me as I grew, as a person and as an advocate. And even though it seemed like we were helping them, they taught me and molded me, and I learned to welcome and embrace them with all my heart. I remember the many young students organized by KRC struggling to continue their education as schools were wrongfully denying them admission based on their undocumented status. I remember domestic violence survivors I met at KRC's legal clinic, fearful of leaving their abusive husbands because they may lose custody of their children. There have been victories and also disappointments. I experienced firsthand clients overcoming tremendous constant vulnerability of government safety nets and programs that affect the most in need. I know that KRC and Nakasek have a deep understanding of what we must do to move forward, not just to help our individual clients, but also in addressing systemic injustice. It is at the core of their work and their mission, and we are so grateful to be a part of that. And as we continue to push on, I hope all of you will also continue to involve yourselves in this fight against injustice. Because we know that in the words of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., the arc of the moral universe is long, but it bends towards justice. I know that LAFLA will always be a partner with KRC and Nakasek to use the tools that we have in whatever
capacity. 네, 이혜영 디렉터님, 그 크리스탈 씨, 정말 감사합니다. 네, 식사하시는 중인 거 알지만 정말 이상 수사하자는 시카고 할인 교육 문화 만화집의 최인혜 사무국장님께서 해주시겠습니다.
Now, if you could give full attention to people who are getting awards and honorees, because it's for them such a valuable moment. So I would appreciate if you could be more, encouraged and give full attention to all the awardees and honorees who deserve to get these awards. So once again, thank you, Joanne and Crystal, for the awards. And the next is Inhe Choi, from Executive Director of KRCC in Chicago, will present the first honoree. Please help me welcome to the stage, Inhe Choi.
Good evening. It is my honor to present the 2014 Standing Up for Justice Award to the Evelyn and Walter Haas Jr. Fund. Guided by the values of fairness, equality, and opportunity, the fund supports organizations that confront injustice and some of the society's most difficult issues, such as immigrant rights, as we know well, gay, lesbian, bisexual, transgender rights, and improve the lives of low-income families and children. Nakasek and KRC are very fortunate to have been a long-time grantee. I'm thrilled to introduce Mr. Matt Foreman, who will receive the Standing Up for Justice Award on behalf of the Evelyn and Walter Haas Jr. Fund.
I do have a very long prepared speech here, which I am not going to give in the interest of time. I know you'll all be upset about that. Just two things. I speak for Kathy Cha, who does our immigrant rights work, and everyone else at the Haas Jr. Fund to say, we're so proud of the work and the institution that really is courageous in taking a stand on social justice issues. My experience over many years is people that have money, our founders are descendants of Levi Strauss, the jeans company, so they have money. My experience with people who have money is they do three things. They either never give it away, or they use money to keep themselves wealthy, or in some kind of elite position by giving to cultural institutions or something safe, or you have people like our founders and our trustees who say, you know what, we're gonna do something good with our money. So I'm very proud to work in an organization that's done that and has taken on for 60 years some really hard, tough issues and stuck with it. So this year we crossed 100, we're not a big foundation, but this year we crossed $100 million in supporting the two most contentious issues, civil rights issues in our country, gay rights and immigrant rights. So I'm very proud to come from a place like that. That we are able to support organizations like KRC and Nakasek that are doing the hard work of changing our country. I don't have to go down the list. I have the list of big accomplishments here. I'm not going to go down them. You know them. This is such an important. These two organizations are so vital to changing what's going on in our nation. We could not be more proud or more grateful to be able to support them. So thank you very much.
네, 핫시디 펀드의 맥 여러분이 많이 보셨던 비디오에 나오시는 분이에요. 자세한 소개는 미디어업의 이사님이신 베키 벨코 이사님께서 소개해 주시겠습니다.
The next honoree is someone who appears in many of the promotional videos you have seen thus far. Becky Belcour, Nakasag and KRC board member, will present this award. So please help me welcome Becky.
Hello everyone, good evening. My name is Becky Belcour. I'm here from Nakasag Chicago affiliate KRCC, also with Zuri Belcour and Mia McMillan, also from Chicago. Here, so proud to present a Standing Up for Justice Award to the Service Employees International Union. With over 2 million members, SEIU is one of this country's strongest advocates for immigrant and worker rights. Nakasag could not have sustained the Fast for Families campaign without their fierce commitment and their leadership. We truly thank them for their tireless work to make this world a better place for working people, immigrants, and their families. Please join me in welcoming Rocio Science and accepting the award on behalf of SEIU. Thank you.
Good evening, everybody. Thank you so much for this recognition and award to SEIU. I just want to say that this is for us, Nakasag. We really thank you for the work you do every day to improve the lives of people in our community. And you know, I just want to say the energy, the dedication, the commitment that Nakasag has given us, not only to the AAPI community, but to the whole range, the whole immigrant community, is just beyond impressive. And on behalf of our president, Mary Kay Henry, our immigrant justice leader, Eliseo Medina, and our SEIU leaders and locals in the table here present, we really thank you for the work you do. And I just cannot go without sharing a little bit about, you know, the Fast for Families, because we know that without you, Nakasag, and your executive director, DJ Dion, we wouldn't have been where we were during that time. So, and the staff and the work that you did around there was really great. And we know that DJ, you know, when at the times that people didn't believe or didn't really see or bought into the Fast for Families, DJ Young, he knew, he was there, he didn't hesitate, and he put himself right there. And it was your team and your work and your commitment, along with everybody, that we felt at that moment that we were part of a huge, big family, that we believed that change was possible. But not only after the month that he spent under the tent, DJ, he also came in and joined us to the Fast for Family bus tour, where they went to 30 states and from California all the way to DC, continue to send a message that we wanted to see immigration reform now and that we won't give up, just like now. And as he has said, we won't give up. We know it's a time of, like, it's a matter of time, not if we win immigration reform. And together, we all know that we will see that happen. So we really thank you for all of that. And just with that, I wanted to say that you know, it's been an incredible work that together we're going to build an agenda that works for everybody, for all workers, for all people in this country. So we really thank you for the work you do every day to make our movement grow stronger, to know that we're going to win, and to know that we're making this country better. So thank you for that. And I just want to say, si se puede, yes we can, ya Yusita. Thank you.
SEI의 루시오 씨 그리고 백효가 어려서부터 이렇게 어른의 성장되기까지 청년이 된 것처럼 차세대 커뮤니티들도 지도자들로 성장하는 모습을 영상으로 잠시 담아봤습니다.
Attorney and longtime supporter of CARE-CC and NACSEC. So let's give a big round of applause to Carmen.
Thank you. I'm honored tonight to give an award to Tadeng. Tadeng came to the United States from the Philippines when he was 12 years old. He worked at the Albany Park Neighborhood Council in the spring of 2013. He joined KRCC's Youth Leadership Council, fighting youth shouting out loud for humanity, FISH. Tadeng demonstrated leadership immediately and made an impact not only at FISH, but throughout the entire immigrant community. Tadeng's selfless action, thoughtful leadership, and commitment to immigrant and human rights resonate well with the goals of the 2014 Standing Up for Justice Award. Tadeng?
Hi everyone, my name is Tadeng and I'm honored to receive this award. I'm part of KRCC's FISH, which stands for Fighting Youth, Shouting Out for Humanity. And FISH is a social justice group and we focus mainly on immigrant rights and immigration reform. We have worked very hard this year and the years before to get CIR passed, and we will continue fighting until immigration reform is achieved. On November of last year, I flew to DC to participate in the Fast for Families campaign to get Congress to put CIR up for a vote. I fasted along with DJ and Eliseo and many others. And it was very inspirational to see the determination of the solidarity fasters. They definitely earned my respect because I know the hardships they must have felt fasting and even missing Thanksgiving just to get their opinions across.
and was asked quite a lot why I decided to join the FAST. I responded that youths have powers too, and we have to use those powers to struggle. I was more motivated because of the Children Over Politics campaign. And I was more educated about organizing because of the civic camp. I, along with other youth leaders, continued organizing in Chicago for an event called Coffee House, which is a talent show where all the proceeds go to Fish's Dream Scholarship.
받으셨던 분이시죠? 사이먼 전 씨입니다.
The next awardee will be presented by the winner of the last year's Youth Dream Awardee, Simon Jung.
Okay. Hi, my name is Simon, and it is an honor to introduce you to all to the recipient of the Dream National Award, Yamlex Rusian. It has only been 3 weeks that I've known Yamlex, and even though I've only known her for a brief period of time, I consider her my sister and my role model. At the age of 18, she organized a youth solidarity fest in front of Union Station to raise awareness for the ongoing humanitarian crisis that is happening. During the fest, she encouraged those who are feeling weak, raised attention to the cries of help from the children that are being detained, and ignited the passion to fight for those who are in need. As I watched her passion and her unwavering resolve, I couldn't help but to look up to her in inspiration. You'll forever be my friend, my sister, and my inspiration. So can everybody please give a warm welcome to Yamlex?
Thank you, Simon, for that amazing introduction. Before I start, I want to say a few thanks. I want to thank NACASEC and KRC for being, thank you for the work you do and for supporting us. It truly means a lot. I also want to say that it truly means a lot that we all came together for this, for this big experience that really truly meant a lot to me. The reason why I decided to fast was because 12 years ago, my mom's a janitor, and thanks to our president, David Huerta, I remember walking with him, the precinct, and he would tell me why he does this work and why it's so important to him. And that's how I got inspired, because it's great people, great leaders like David Huerta that inspired me. I just want to say thank you from the bottom of my heart. I never thought that, you know, an 18-year-old can organize the fast. 12 years ago, I was one of these children that had to cross the border because I had no choice. My dad was shot in Guatemala, and my mom was already here looking for the American dream. And when I heard the news about these children, I saw myself in the face of them, and I knew that we had to do something. I didn't want to go down to Marietta and fight those people that were screaming at them, but I wanted to show the other side of humanity, and I wanted to show that this is not about politics, that we all deserve to have equal rights. And during this fast, I got the chance to meet
seven amazing people, our core pastors, if you guys can stand up. These seven people taught me something very important. During the week that we fasted, I knew that I didn't make just friends that I would see down the hall, but I made lifetime friends that would definitely be there for me, and I consider them my brothers and sisters. They've also taught me that it doesn't matter what age we are, that we can still make a change. Children over politics, well, you know, it's very important because it just shows that it doesn't matter how old we are, that we can still be the change we want to see in the world. And lastly, I want to thank once again NACASEC and KRC for all the work that you do. It doesn't matter if we're Latinos or Koreans. We're all immigrants and we all deserve equal opportunities. I also want to thank... Lastly, I want to thank once again USWW. Thank you for being great support. Thank you to the members. You guys truly have done our great.
Ne, 정말 힘찬 응원 감사드립니다. 네, 다음 마지막 청소년 드림자 수상자인데요. 소개는 민족학교 이민자 권익 캠페인 코디네이터 에스터 킹 씨가 해주시겠습니다.
Next, we will have our last Your Dream awardee presented by Esther Kim.
Good evening. I've worked side by side with someone these past two summers at KRC. Last year, we focused mainly on deferred action and naturalization applications, while this year we put our attention towards a variety of campaigns. Throughout this time, I was able to watch someone really develop his leadership skills in so many different ways. Some examples include walking community members step by step through unfamiliar processes, developing plans and strategies for campaigns, and educating our community about their rights. But I was especially moved by his ability to teach and guide others in doing his line of work. I saw someone grow tremendously within KRC. I realized that at the core of his growth was his dedication to helping others and his passion for lifting the stories of the marginalized. Someone was a motivating person to work with during these past two summers. He is an absolute inspiration to me today, as I know he will continue his passion and desire to help and empower his community. Without further ado, it is my honor and privilege to introduce the recipient of today's Dream and Action Award, Seongwon Hong.
I came prepared. I want to thank Esther for introducing me such a great way. I feel like anything she just said I don't deserve this award, but yeah, thank you. That was a nice introduction. Hello, my name is Seongwon Hong. I came to the United States when I was 11 years old. I am currently a third-year student at UC Davis, and I am also undocumented. I was first introduced to the Korean Resource Center in the summer of 2012. After having just graduated from high school, I was not doing anything productive. I was not doing anything productive other than watching Korean dramas at home. And my mom was not happy about this. For this reason, I was basically forced to go to KRC and serve the community. That was already 2 years ago. And when I first started working at the Korean Resource Center, I often faced puzzling moments and made multiple mistakes. However, as I continued working, my responsibility grew in number along with my personality. Because of the Korean Resource Center, I had many opportunities to step out of my comfort zone and serve the community, especially this summer. When I first, I had a chance to attend the first time ever Asian Pacific Islander Undocumented Youth Convening. At the convening, I met a lot of API undocumented youth all over the nation. From this convening, I learned that even though we have the same status, we all face different situations and problems depending on which part of the states we came from. After the convening, I participated as documenter for the public disobedience that took place in front of the Congressman at Royce's office, who represents the city of Burrell. I also organized the petition drive that demanded immigration reform at the Hanam Chain supermarket and the different faith groups around the city. Lastly, I participated as one of the core pastors for the Children Over Politics pastor in hopes of bringing awareness towards the issue of the Central American children who are fleeing from the violence. I want to acknowledge my fellow brothers and sisters who participated with me. Yamalex, Bell, Kenya, and Hanyo. It was my honor to fast with this wonderful people, and it was such a great 일이었습니다. 아까 에서 씨가 소개해 주신 것과 같이 제 이름은 홍성원이고 11살 때 미국으로 이민을 왔습니다. 현재는 UC 데이비스에서 3학년으로 재학 중이고요. 그리고 서류 미비자입니다. 2012년 여름부터 민족학교에서 봉사를 시작했습니다. 제가 민족학교에 오게 된 계기는 처음에는 어머니께서 봉사라도 하라고 권하셔서 얼떨결에 문을 열고 들어갔습니다. 그런데 그게 벌써 2년 전입니다. 처음에는 실수도 많이 하고 당황했던 순간들도 많이 있었습니다. 하지만 시간이 흐르면서 제가 민족학교에서 참여하는 활동이 많아졌습니다. 민족학교를 통해서 여러 가지 일이 있었고 많은 것을 배웠습니다. 그 중에서 올 여름은 저에게 잊지 못할 방학이 될 것 같습니다. 아텍의 서류 유비자들과 샌프란시스코에서 만나서 서로의 고충을 듣고 앞으로 우리가 무엇을 해야 하는지 이야기를 나누는 기회를 주었습니다. 또 브레아 지역을 대표하는 하원의원 에드로이스 사무실 앞에서 이민자들과 함께 불만을 표출하는 시위도 했습니다. 그리고 한남체인과 성당에서 이민개혁을 촉구하는 서명운동을 계획하고 또 참여를 했습니다. 그 후에는 중남미 아이들을 위해서 금식을 했습니다. 5일간의 금식이 끝났을 때는 저에게 7명의 새로운 가족이 생겼습니다. 야무렉스, 케냐, 벨, 엘리스, 에드거, 그리고 하니. 이 모든 활동은 저에게 너무 낯설었습니다. 하지만 저를 성장시킬 수 있는 기회라고 생각하고 모두 참여했습니다. 만약 민족학교에 오지 않았더라면 이런 기회를 놓쳤을 것입니다. 제가 지칠 때마다 응원과 격려를 해주신 모든 스태프들에게 감사하다는 말을 드리고 싶습니다. 그리고 제가 용기를 내어서 할 수 있었던 것은 제가 꿈꾸는 세상은 모든 사람들이 평등하게 사는 세상이기 때문입니다. 저를 비롯한 많은 사람들이 이런 사회를 만들기 위해서 노력할 것입니다. 서를 유기자들한테도 기회를 줄 수 있는 사회를 만드는 활동을 하는데 많은 관심과 참여를 부탁드립니다. 그리고 마지막으로 너무나 당연한 일을 한 저에게 상을 주셔서 너무 감사하고 비록 학교 때문에 곧 떠나지만은 항상 멀리서나마 민족학교와 낙하세계 활동을 응원하겠습니다. 고맙습니다.
김현철! Undocumented! Thank you so much.
네, 저희가 마지막 프로그램에 있기 전에 여기 오늘 나와주신 스페셜 게스트 분 두 분을 소개시켜 드릴게요. 이분들과 같이 함께 이 자리에 있게 돼서 정말 영광을 생각하는데요. 한 분은 Eliseo Medina, SEIU International에 계신 분이시죠. 이번에 DJ 사무국장님이랑 같이 단식하신 정말 정말 대단한 훌륭하신 배울게 많으신 분입니다.
Can you raise your hand?
네.
Thank you so much for coming on the support.
이번에 LA 카운슬 멤버 시의원에 출마하시는 분이시죠. 저희가 82년도 이후로는 아시안 시의원이 없었다고 하니 여러분 많이 이번에 선거에 많은 교육과 참여 부탁드립니다. 직접 어떤 프로그램으로 진행되었는지 잠시 들어보는 시간 가지도록 하겠습니다.
Also this week, a cultural education camp for children was held for the first time in our organization's history. We will now welcome the youth leaders of our community to listen to firsthand accounts of what they have experienced. Can you give big them a round of applause, please?
박수 부탁드립니다.
'Cause it was fun. I got to shoot my first arrows during archery. I learned at least 5 new card games. And I think we could have set a world record for the number of rounds of Mafia we played. I also met a lot of new people that I genuinely liked, but I wouldn't have gotten a chance to meet without camp. Camp wasn't only about the fun we had. Most of the day, we stayed inside to practice, getting complaints from other campers because we were too loud. Practicing for 5 hours straight every day was a given. I know that right now most of us have painful blisters on our hands from all the practice. At this point in my wonderful speech, I would like to address our teacher. He taught us for an entire week, showing his passion and his love for Pumu. He listened to all of our complaints. Sam! 감사합니다. 연습할 때도 쌤이 너무 재밌게 만들고요. 목이 쉬도록 가르치면서 정말 감동받았어요. 쌤 사랑해요. Being the oldest of the Chicagoans, I was given responsibilities that got me a step model, don't talk during practice, keep track and take care of the kids. But I realized it was a privilege rather than an annoyance, and I realized that those responsibilities become. I want to thank everyone who made this possible. When I first arrived, I thought it would be the worst week of my life. But then on the last day, it surprised me how sad I was that it was over. I'm genuinely thankful for this opportunity that I had, and I hope to have it again next year. Thank you so much.
Hi, I'm Jun Sung Kim, a 15-year-old, and I'm from LA. I just want to share my experience at the culture camp. When I was first told by my parents that I was coming here, and I didn't really want to go. I mean, I didn't want to practice for like 5 hours a day for Pumul, but I'm happy that I went, because I met many new friends from Chicago, Korea, and Southern California, and yeah. Pumul was taught by Hyojin Sungkim. He came from Korea just to teach us. And he was one of the best teachers I ever had, both in or out of school. The counselors also set up a lot of good activities like archery and ceramics. And I learned a lot about our Korean American history and about our identity. The food was also pretty good, and the site was also pretty good too. But out of all the things I gained from this camp, I believe that the most important thing was leadership. As the oldest kid in the whole camp, you know, I had a lot of responsibilities, and No, I found myself having to be more assertive and having to connect with others and direct them toward whatever we were doing. And no, I just want to say thank you to everyone who made this possible and contributed to the creation of our first culture camp. And I hope to do this next year. Yeah.
Bear with us. Sorry about the little bit of technical.
저희가 이런 캠프를 계속 유지해 나갈 수 있도록 종잣돈을 조금 만들어 보려고 그러는데요. 오늘 이 자리에서 목표는 만불입니다.
Now this year we didn't have any funding to support our camp. But thanks to the dedication of parents and teachers and volunteers as well as personal donations from and planning for fundraiser events by NACASAC, KRC, and KRCC, we're able to work together and make the camp a successful. Now today, we must provide the seed money to secure to fund for our young people to participate in the cultural and youth civic engagement camp. And our goal today is to raise $10,000.
여기서 만불을 할 수 있을 거라고 저는 생각하고요. 자, 어느 분이 불씨를 당겨주시겠습니까?
Now, I believe that we will raise $10,000 tonight. So, who will start off by contributing $2,000?
저희 오늘 2,000불을 하실 수 있을 거라고 믿어요. 오늘 이 자리에서 2,000불이 나올 수 있을 거라고 믿는데요. 저희가 카운트를 한번 해볼까요?
Yeah.
저희가 캠프를 후원해 주실 분 2,000불을 찾고 있습니다. 마지막으로 부탁드리면서 저희가 카운트를 한번 해볼게요. 하나,
원,
둘,
투. I know someone out there.
둘, 반,
2 and a half. We keep counting.
Oh,
there we go.
뒤에 있습니다.
Thank you so much. That's $2,000 right there. We got $8,000 left.
와, 정말 감사드립니다. 저희가 만불에서 지금 2,000불을 뺀 8,000불이 남았어요. 저희 기억하시죠? 오늘 도네이션 하는 펀드는 두 배가 된다는 거예요. 저희가 8,000불이 있는데 또 2,000불 또 있을까요?
Anyone else who could donate $2,000? And you could also make a monthly payment. Table 10, no, they're youth. How about table 15?
15번
table 20. 21.
저희가 10불을 하셔도 한 달에 거의 83불을 통해서 저희 차세대를 지원하실 수 있으세요.
I think we have pause to KRC and NACASAC. Anyone? Can you raise your hand? Stand up. Thank you so much. That's $1,000. Now we got $7,000 to go. Now we ain't going home until we raise $10,000. Can you lock the $7,000 to go?
저희가 500불 가도록 하겠습니다.
All right, fine. $1,000 right here. There we go. This is $6,000. Thank you so much for your support. We got $6,000. Thank you so much. We got 5,000. There's another right there.
저기 가십니다. 와.
Thank you.
주영 씨가 또 춤을 추신다고 합니다.
Okay, fine. We got low to $500. If you guys donate, I'm willing to dance. I will go all out. Unless you guys want to see it, it's okay. 500. There we go. 500. Table 3. How much is that? $4,500 left. There's another one right there. Raise your hand. Thank you so much for your support. That's 4,000?
Is it 4,000?
We got 4,000. We already raised 6,000.
아이들이 돌아가면서 도네이션을 받고 있는데 앞으로도 이런 캠프를
500?
I think you should mention Jason.
저기 아이.
That's it. There's a baby donating $500. There's a raise. How courageous is this? What?
Oh my goodness.
So we are down to
3,500.
I can't do this, I need a drink. So let's get this over to business first. $3,500.
500불 더 하면은 더 주신대요.
Yes. So why don't we... I continue to... I'm getting like tired now. But we want to introduce one of the parents
In the Chicago area, right?
The Chicago area, his name is Jason Lee, and he will just briefly share his story, how NACASAC and KRC and KRCC has changed his life. Jason? Yeah.
Go ahead, go ahead.
안녕하세요. I'm from Chicago. I'm one of the kids' parents. I think Jason is somewhere in the back, so I came here to talk about it. 먼저 저는 그 시카고에 딸 하나하고 아들 하나를 둔 아빠입니다. 그런데 제 딸이 여기 장군을 쳤고요. 부부를 또 아들 쳤는데 이번에 캠프를 한 일주일 같이 갔어요. 처음에 이걸 시작할 때는 이제 그 마당집, 시카고에 있는 마당집하고 민주학교에 있는 그 스태프들이나 어떤 자원봉사자들의 아들, 딸들이 모여가지고 한번 같이 이렇게 캠프를 만들어보자 이런 취지로 했는데 이렇게 주위에서 소문을 듣고 또 한국에서 오고 또 시카고 외 다른데 뉴저지라든가 또는 다른 그 미주 타지역에서 오고 그래가지고 한 27명이 모였었어요. 그래가지고 이게 우리도 정말 생각도 못하게 그게 이렇게 성공한 캠프가 됐는데 제가 옆에서 이제 둘이 아들과 딸들과 다른 자녀들이 하는 모습을 보고 너무나 기분 좋았고 너무나 그 감동스러웠어요. 제가 어렸을 때 이런 기회가 있었으면 참 좋았겠다라는 생각이 있고요. 그래서 저는 이제 이런 기회를 우리 자녀만이 아니고 예를 들어서 이제 우리 스태프들이라든가 발런티어들 자녀만이 아니고 좀 더 넓혀가지고 동포 사회의 모든 그 청소년들이 캠프를 참여할 수 있었으면 좋겠다. 그 내년에 올해가 처음인데 내년에는 좀 더 계속 이걸 이어 나갔으면 좋겠다라는 생각으로 이제 이렇게 좀 기금을 좀 마련해보자라는 아이들을 그 서로 냈고요. 그래서 좀 많이 좀 참여해 주시면 고맙겠습니다. 감사합니다. So we invited all other friends of our children from Korea and from New Jersey, from other places in the United States. And then they participated in one week camp. And as a parent, we all participated together. So throughout this one week camp, all those children were children of volunteers from KRC and the KRCC in Chicago. So we thought that we should not limit the children participating in this camp, not only to the KRCC or KRC members or staff volunteers. We should expand this to outside, more expanded to Korean American community throughout the U.S. So we would really want to promote this camp annually and then get more funding from you guys and then from outside so we can continue this on with other Korean American communities. So I really appreciate your support. Thank you.
네, 지금 저희가 좋은 소식을 들었는데요. 저희가 아이들이 돌아가면서 거의 만불을 다 모았다고 하네요. 지금 적고 계시는 분들도 있는데 너무너무 감사드립니다.
Now, I just heard from the insider that we just raised $10,000. Man, thank you all so much for your help and contribution. It's time to party. I don't know if you guys been to our fundraising dinner last year, but you know we always have our traditional thing that we do at the end of the program, and we do dance final with 한누리, 일가누리, 바람소리, 일가누리 팀, 장국학당, and will now take place. And today's final performance is 강강소래 올래, and the camp participant will lead you to the dance. So please enjoy.
네, 다시.
네, 안녕하세요. 예. 네. 저, 이제 마지막 행사인 것 같습니다. 모두 다 같이 자리에서 일어서서 한국에서 이런 큰 잔치가 열리면 마지막으로 함께 같이 하는 프로그램이 있어요. 그게 강강술래인데 다 같이 의자에서 일어서서 선에 선을 잡고 하나의 큰 원을 만들어 보도록 하겠습니다.
Hi, as a final activities, we're gonna have all joint movement together, which called Gangnam Suwole, and we're gonna stand up. So stand up everyone and pull your chair into the table and we
We're gonna make a snail.
골자 골자
덕성 골자. With a song.
골자 골자 덕성 골자.
고신난다 덕성 골자.
골자 골자 덕성 골자.
골자 골자 덕성 골자.
골자 골자 덕성 골자.
귀여운다 덕성 골자.
골자 골자 덕성 골자.
귀여운다 덕성 골자.
골자 골자 덕성 골자.
귀여운다 덕성 골자.
풀자 풀자 덕성 풀자.
귀여운다 덕성 풀자.
풀자 풀자 덕성 풀자.
We're gonna release this snail.
풀자 풀자 덕성 풀자.
Original circle.
풀자 풀자 덕성 풀자.
전난다 덕성 풀자.
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 문제기 문제기 문 열어주소.
열쇠 없어서 문 열겠네.
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 문제기 문제기 문 열어 주소.
열쇠 없어서 문 열겠네.
문제기 문제기 문 열어주소.
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 열쇠 없어서 문 열겠네.
강강술래
강강술래
강강술래.
Anyone who went through this door,
강강술래.
Make a one step again. So the door is ending now. So make a circle again.
원으로 만들어 보세.
강강술래.
우리 모두 손 맞잡고.
강강술래.
원으로 만들어 보세.
강강술래.
우리 모두 손을 잡고.
강강술래.
원을 만들어 움직여 보세.
강강술래.
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 열어보세
강강술래 강강술래
할 말이 다 하여보세
강강술래
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 우리 모두 손을 잡고
강강술래
없이
강강술래
얼추고 얼추고 잘 도돈다
강강술래 강강술래 강강술래
손에 손을 마주 잡고
강강술래
없이 뛰어나보세
강강술래
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 Now we're gonna make a big one circle
밤새가 놀아라
졸래졸래가 잘 논다
밤새가 놀아라
졸래졸래가 잘 논다 졸래졸래가 잘 논다 졸래졸래가 남자들 나와 노세요 남자들 나와 노세요 Oh male Please come out
얼씨고 잘 도논다
강강술래
남자들은 신나게 놀고
강강술래
오늘 한번 재밌게 노세
강강술래
다 놀았으면 들어가라
강강 이제 어 매일
얼씨고 절씨고 잘 도논다
강강술래
우리 모두 신나게 놀아
강강술래
오늘 밤을
강술래
아이들만 놀아보자
Now
부모들은 박수치고
강강술래
얼씨고 절씨고 잘 도논다
강강술래 강술래
다갈다갈 붙으소서
강강술래
오늘 오신 여러분들
강강술래 강강술래
반대 비전을 비웁니다
강강술래
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 마지막으로 신나게 풍물 한번 치면서
Yeah.